With most people in any art form, our love of it came from our association with people who mentored us or who taught us and who stayed in our lives. And they modeled for us the good behavior on how to make room in an adult workaday lifestyle for music. And I hope you don't mind if I mention a few names in this regard.
Please.
Because as I began law school at the University of Michigan, I met an appellate court judge by the name of Myron
Wallace. Hold on. You mean you spent time in Detroit where Kenny is from?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Kenny knows where my first house was, where my wife and Connie and I built a living and then sold before coming out here in the mid-80s. But I met this judge on the Court of Appeals whose name was Myron Walls. He's a Chicago fellow, hometown.
My hometown.
And he grew up around Ramsey Lewis and that group over there.
Oh, my God.
And he was a pro.
You're going to make me cry.
Yeah.
Well, go ahead.
He hired me to be his law clerk, which did two things for me. One is that it sprang me into this job, because law degrees don't get you into teaching unless you do an apprenticeship in something that tests you in the fire of both writing and analysis, and law clerking does that. So he sprung me into this job. But he took summers off to go on the road in Europe with the Lionel Hampton Band, and he played keyboards for Lionel Hampton. And he would come back to Detroit and expect that his cases would all be written and caught up on. That was my job. And then he would tell me all these stories about what would happen when Ahmad Jamal would elbow him off the piano, and he would play, and they would tour in this place and that place. And you know what that did for me? That let me know that no matter what my day job, I could find room for music. And when I came to Pepperdine, I immediately began looking for opportunities to play with students and with other professionals, some of whom were in their worship band or others that recorded but kept day jobs, like one of my colleagues here, Scott Weckel, who is a master's expertise in guitar, who happens to be a former pupil of Kenny. And I think he knows everything there is to know about.
This is incestuous, you know that.
Yes, it is.
All right, go ahead,
but
please.
He's an example of what happens to people like me who get workaday jobs outside of the field, but because we had good mentors, Kenny, we now know how to keep a foot in the business. Isn't that wonderful? And that's exactly how it happened. And I've stayed with it. And every year, a different group of students do it. And one of my reasons for being here is that the students that are here in Seaver and graduate school who want to continue to play, along with Mark Russo, who plays a mean saxophone, I've been led to believe, will sign up for this year's band.